This video is a complement to other videos where we foresee that certain CEOs soon will be removing all post-industrial carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, establishing unseen sustainability, as well as establishing unseen human thriving and sustainable lifestyles, this voluntarily and largely also in the CEOs and ordinary humans' own interest. This will be certainly so, provided that activists go on supporting their decades-long main claim and demand, and support the above initiatives and if possible also the certifications of practices that realize the removal of all post-industrial carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. We hope that activists and CEOs alike will both appreciate their mutual converging efforts, will come somewhat closer, and eventually intensify or accelerate what is beneficial for the environment and for all 8 billion humans. While the activists' wish will come true, and at no cost for them nor for anyone else, also all remaining climate challenges we 8 billion humans are challenged by every time more, will be consequently solved. As said in other videos, this unedited effort and cooperation will be what the environment and biodiversity needs more, and last but not least will make all 8 billion humans thrive, as it will create some kind of a global horn of abundance, at least of everything that is sustainable, and that is all what we need and have today, and this in advanced versions compared to what we have now. No one will need to give in. Our claim of all 8 billion humans thriving, as well as the bias claimed horn of abundance, is the subject of several other of our videos. The thriving of humans and horn of abundance obviously are closely related to making certain or all countries being made great again. So it should be expected that several now quite polar parties would come somewhat closer together, and would work better together, something which obviously also or maybe in the first place will be beneficial for the activists for them to have the needed success with their main objectives in time, but also for them to live in a better world than all 8 billion living humans live in today. The other very essential challenge of humans already is and will be the degeneration of 90% of agricultural soils worldwide, this by the year 2050, which is only 25 years from now. At least that would be so without this by us hoped for cooperation. The then obvious consequential lack of affordable food worldwide obviously will aggravate all tensions, divisions, and conflicts. At least that would be so without this by us hoped for cooperation. Some of the most influential CEOs of the world perceive national debts as one of the greatest challenges. They see artificial intelligence and robots as the only way out. Well, we foresee that also they will have or support what they say is essential, and if they are right, all or many countries will have what they need to sustain and to thrive, and to not enter into any form of collapse. Mining and drilling will become redundant and unproductive. Perhaps surprisingly for many, carbon agroforests are massive and efficient bedrock weathering agents, soil and fertilizer producers as well as miners of bedrock and deep soil and accumulate interesting and essential resources in a number of the elements that compose them, this at least so when these carbon agroforests are not incorrectly managed and not unnecessarily disturbed. Further, and perhaps also surprisingly for many, gasification of biomass is extremely efficient and in fact natural. It certainly is not burning. Gasification of biomass will produce a variety of renewable products that will be renewable equivalents or superiors of all what petrochemy produces, except this will be produced in decentralized eco-friendly ways, without any rest products or pollution. After all the ingredients of the cooking are organic biomass, without exception, no chemicals are needed, nor would chemicals be cost-effective. Like for instance renewable drop-in fuels that will remove more carbon dioxide than they will emit in case they would be burned, which could be less than 25% of its production. In the worst case that all would be burned, there will be netto removal and no netto emission, so neutral. In all cases, the cooking or gasification for gasoline likes and fuels or drop-in fuels would represent massive removal of carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere, or CDR. Simply because massive production of biomass goes hand in hand with massive removal out of the atmosphere. Nobody needs to do anything, because the biomass producing trees and plants will do this all automatically, just as they always did, except that their conditions should be more favorable than without humans intervening. Ideally, humans and cities would have their organic food and other waste composted, and this next to any eventual organic remains from traditional agriculture should end up in the soils of these carbon agroforests. In case you like the here proposed initiative or action plan, or carbon agroforest economy, or the information in this video, Please subscribe to this channel, leave a comment, question, or a like on this video. This and other videos of this channel are translated and/or dubbed in over 5 languages. This for this initiative and plan to succeed. To unite all 8 billion humans across the world, in and through this carbon agroforest action plan and economy.